If I had to do all over again, there's one thing I would change about the coilover conversion kit. First off, let me clarify a few things. I love the kit. It's done really good for me, especially in the comfort department, I guess. Richard has helped me throughout the whole process. Again, I can't speak highly enough of the whole kit and Richard's customer service, but there's only one thing I would change, and that's the shocks. I can't seem to have good success with them. I don't know if it's user error or if it's it seems to only be the driver's side. Let me show you what I'm talking about. The problem I seem to keep having is the cap that goes right in here where the shaft is. There's a little cap that keeps it sealed. That's where I keep having problems. The cap seems to always get damaged and thus problems. And I was really looking forward to giving it a real world test with some off-roading. Even though I've already done probably over 1500 miles of daily driving, but I was really looking forward to taking it off-road to see how it held up. Well, it's the weekend and I'm finally able to test the coilover conversion. So we're gonna go up to Oklahoma to run a few trails, but first, food. Well, we're in Oklahoma. We're at Wichita National Forest, just north of Broken Bow. We're gonna run a few trails just to see how the coilover conversion runs. And I don't know how technical it will be. I've never run this trail before, so we'll see. I've been taking it kind of easy on these roads, and there's a fairly steep hill behind me with a little bit of off camber. So I'm gonna add a little bit of juice to it and see what it is. We just broke camp for the day. The road we used to come up to camp was pretty technical, and it got pretty flexy, so I'm excited about recording that. Not really sure where we're gonna go next. It's up in the air, I guess. We'll see.
front of me. Oh my god. Come here. Huge snake. A huge snake. Come here. But in this log. This is the side. Oh my god.
Let me take it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I heard him and he.
So Fifi says there's a snake.
Oh my god.
Over here.
It's behind here.
It's behind this log.
Oh my god.
Right here.
You see it?
No, I don't.
Oh my god.
Fifi found it. I don't know if you can see. There you go. Not quite sure what kind of snake that is. But I don't necessarily want to get close enough to find out. Yeah, I'm not sure what kind of snake that is. If you know, comment below.
Okay, so just to recap a few things, and I guess whether or not I recommend the kit and what I think of it. So throughout the whole time we were off-roading, the main thing I noticed was how comfortable it was compared to the torsion keys. Going over bumps, dips, everything, like it the feedback was very minimal. So I would definitely suggest it. The only thing, I would change would actually be to buy the brackets separately than the coils and the actual shocks, because there are tons of choices you can actually choose from. I went with the 650-pound coils just for the heavy bumper and the winch up front. So you go softer or harder if you want to, but regardless, I would definitely suggest buying the kit. It made a huge difference on how comfortable off-roading was. I guess if you like this video, then I guess give me some feedback. Thanks for watching.